Well, I'm going to call to the stage here now Barb and Daryl Foster. They know firsthand the power of support groups to enrich lives and to remind you that you are not alone. They're facilitators of the Swift Current Support Group and are happy to share their firsthand experience of the benefits of support group. Why don't you welcome them as they come?
Good afternoon, everyone. Can you hear me okay in the back? How about now? Is that better? Okay. Barb and I would like to thank Parkinson's Saskatchewan for inviting us to do this workshop, and we hope our experiences will encourage you to either attend a group or to start one in your community. How we discovered the support group was in spring of 2008. I noticed a slight tremor in my right hand. I actually thought my truck needed a wheel balance, but that wasn't to be the case. Unknown to me, it related to Parkinson's, and I was experiencing many other non-motor symptoms such as stiffness, shuffling, loss of smell, facial masking, constipation, and sleep disturbances. In the fall of 2008, my family physician initially diagnosed me with Parkinson's and referred me to a neurologist who confirmed the diagnosis in December. We didn't know anything about Parkinson's, so we were struggling emotionally and fearful with what the future would hold for us and how this disease would progress or affect us. We had spent the last number of winters in the Palm Desert, California area, and in January 2009, we noticed an announcement about an event about Parkinson's in the local paper. We attended hoping to learn more about this disease. We found that it was to be a weekly support meeting for the Parkinson's and the caregiver. We have been attending these groups in the winter ever since. I was fortunate that in the Palm Desert group we had a nurse practitioner from the Movement Disorder Clinic that facilitated our meetings. How the support group has helped me is the tips gathered from others with a similar problem to mine. And two Parkinsonians have the same journey with the disease, but I can always learn ways to deal with my problem when others with PD share information and ideas for dealing with our common problems on how they have found solutions. I have been inspired by others who have lived with Parkinson's by their courage and determination to fight on. We have been introduced to a wealth of written resources and handouts and aids for making life easier. My special favorite book is titled The Parkinson Disease Treatment Book by Dr. Ray Elskog. He has been a wonderful resource and a guide to this disease. We were also able to attend monthly presentations by a noted Parkinson movement disorder specialist while in California. Now locally, Parkinson Saskatchewan is giving us opportunities to see presentations by a number of Parkinson specialists or other helpful topics through video conferencing available through our local health district. They also supply us with DVDs of presentations and Parkinson's from other areas of the country and wealth of information in pamphlets and booklets. And of course, the education conference provides another opportunity for information. Groups have given us a social outlet and an opportunity to make new friends by meeting people in similar circumstances. In my experience, I know of several people who have Parkinson's who wish to go it alone and not disclose their disease to others. For me, acceptance has been the key, and this has allowed me to live a full and happy life. We are grateful for the support from our family, friends, and other support groups. I have found that the knowledge and experience of others has made my journey easier. I'll turn it over to Barb now.
Hi, pardon me. How has the support group helped me? I was an emotional basket case, feeling sad, angry, and fearful, and asking why us, until we started to attend the support group in Palm Desert. There, the caregivers have their own meeting. I met a number of black belt caregivers who were so encouraging and supportive and willing to share their coping skills and their knowledge. The room is quite often filled with a lot of laughter as we share the daily challenges of living with a partner with Parkinson's. Like Daryl, they've provided me with a wealth of information and resources so I can now be an advocate for Daryl, whether it be at home with his doctor or when we travel. Daryl had hip replacement surgery in 2011, and information gathered at the support group guided us through the hospital stay and surgery. And now, of course, we're so excited in Saskatchewan, we have the Get It On Time program, which is a very similar thing what we had before. It has helped me see that sometimes as a caregiver, I need to ask for help or reduce my load or just take care of me. Sometimes it's hard to remember for me to just put my oxygen mask on first. It's very important that I not mourn the past, because we've had many losses of things that were part of our life and dreams yet to be, and not to be fearful of the future. We have open discussion on our possible plans for our future, along with measures to put our affairs in order. But most importantly, we try to stay in the now, to just live today, and to live each day to the fullest with gratitude and blessings that we have today.
Our groups at Palm Desert really encouraged us to start a group at home. When we shared how we missed being able to attend their meetings when we were not in California. Not knowing where to start, we saw an announcement in the Leader Post about a Parkinson's event in Regina, which was actually their support group meeting. We decided to make the trip to Regina in hopes of meeting someone who could help. We would meet Colleen Crossman, who was a nurse educator for Parkinson's Saskatchewan at the time, and she told us about a couple from Cadillac, about 40 miles south of Swift Current, were also looking for some help and support. They found us a meeting place for free at the local library in Swift Current, and we put in a notice in the local paper, and in 2011, the four of us started the group, and we had 8 people at our first meeting. Colleen attended the first meeting and brought us resources. Today we meet monthly from September to June, and we now have 30 active members. Since our meeting started, we have lost 4 of the Parkinsonians who have passed away, and one has gone into long-term care. We meet all together each month, and only once have separated between Parkinsonians and caregivers. We hope to be able to do that more often.
There are many challenges. Daryl and I act as co-facilitators of our group, and there are many challenges as facilitators and having a support group. And some of those are just tasking the facilitator, and especially if the facilitator has the disease him or herself, because they have reduced energy. And so we're always looking for help, and our group is very supportive, and so we hope to gather more help as time goes by. Meeting places, of course, are another challenge, you know, finding meeting places that meet our needs, large enough and accessible. But how do you start a group? If you know one other person or a couple in your community, you have the basis to start a meeting. And you can start a group and others will come. And sometimes we realize that because it's maybe hard to get a facilitator, there's other ways that you can have a group. You can just gather and meet, or meet somebody for coffee and just talk one-on-one, because often it's a really lonely journey sometimes when you're first diagnosed with this disease. Contact our Parkinson's Saskatchewan office and they'll give you all the assistance you need. Check with the staff at this conference or pick up resources from the display tables. And what do we do at our meetings? Usually they last 1 to 1.5 hours. Each community has a wealth of resources of people, and we have found that on our local health district or other professionals in our community have been very willing to come and do presentations and bring information. Our group has had the speech therapist, the physiotherapist, the occupational therapist, mental health, home care, and a lawyer as an example of some of our guests. Probably just one of our best meetings, though, is when we just go around the table and people share and ask questions and we discover solutions together to our common problem. Parkinson's Saskatchewan has recently developed a monthly topic to help support groups with ideas and resources. This is emailed out each month, and not only to the facilitators but also to members who are willing to share their email addresses. They have also started to have an annual facilitators gathering in the fall to share ideas and give support to facilitators. In closing, none of us have to do this journey with this disease by ourselves. There is information, resources, and people to help if we're willing to lend a hand to spread the word on how to live with Parkinson's. Anybody can start a group. We did, with help, so can you. If you are already in a group, keep attending regularly and spread the word to others. Thank you.